Hello everyone, how to solve this problem for the values of a if we have a minus 2 divided by 2 minus a is equals to 2 and we solve this problem for the values of a. So here we have one condition is that our a is not equals to 2. This means that we solve this problem for other values of 2. Okay. So here first we find all the roots of this equation and at the last we will check that which of these roots are satisfied our given question statement and which of the roots are extraneous root. Further, we solve this problem for two methods. I hope so you like both of these methods, but if you have any other method in your mind, so please don't hesitate to write this method into the comment section. And now here in the first method, you see here in the right hand side, we have this is 2 and the denominator of this term is 1. And now here we need to cross multiply the terms. And when we cross multiply the terms, it will be written as we multiply 1 with this value and it will becomes here a minus 2 is equals to here we multiply 2 minus a with this 2 and it will becomes 2 minus a times of 2. So further in the next step, you see here we have this is a minus 2 is equals to here we multiply 2 on both of these values and it will be written as 2 times of 2 becomes 4 minus this is 2 times of a. And now here in the next step, we need to move this minus 2a in the left hand side and it will becomes a plus this is minus 2a. When we move in the left hand side, it will becomes plus 2a and this is minus 2. When we move it into the right hand side, it will becomes plus 2. And now here further in the next step, we have this is a plus 2a becomes here 3a and this is 4 plus 2 becomes here 6. So because here our target is to find the value of a, so for this we need to divide both of the sides by 3. So when we divide both of the sides by 3, it will be written as this 3 is cancelled out by this 3 and we will get here a is equals to here we again cancel this term and we get here 2, 3 times of 2 becomes here 6. So here we will get the value of a is equals to 2. But now you focus into the given question statement and you see here we have a is not equals to 0. This is the our given condition into the question. So this is not possible. We will choose a equals to 2 because in the given question statement we see here a is not equals to 2. So if a is not equals to 2, this means that we cannot find any value of a other than 2. So finally here we just conclude that this question has no solution, okay, because we cannot find any root of this equation. So here our final conclusion is the no solution. And now we again solve this problem for second method, and in second method we need to copy down given question statement. Here it is a minus 2 divided by 2 minus a is equals to 2, and here we have the condition is that a is not equals to 2. So further in the next step, here in the second method I can just find the value of a into the different approach or different technique, and here at the last we check its behavior. Now you see here you focus in the denominator side. You see here this is 2 minus a and here we need to take common minus sign in the denominator. So when you will take common minus sign from here, you get the negative term become positive and the positive term become negative. So this minus a becomes here plus a and this plus 2 becomes here minus 2. And this is equals to 2. And now further in the next step, you see here this is a minus 2 is cancelled out by this a minus 2 And here we get here 1 over minus 1 is equals to 2. And you clearly see here 1 over minus 1 is equals to minus 1 equals to 2. So you see that here this is not possible case. We just say that minus 1 is not equals to 2 because this is not possible. Minus 1 is equals to 2. This is not possible case. So here in the second method, you see here we cannot find any value of a. We just again say that this question has no solution because here we cannot find any value of a, and we cannot find any root of this equation. And now here we at the last I can just explain the term extraneous root, and you very well know about that. The roots which is satisfied to the given question statement is called the solution of this equation, and the roots which cannot satisfy the given question statement is called the extraneous root of that equation. So here this is our final answer, and thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel for more exciting videos.